It's been a couple of days since the new Art by Marlene 5 collection arrived, and I finally had a chance to play and experiment with some of the products. In today's video, I'll show you my take on the accordion book journal, how I created the background with distress oxide sprays, and then embellished the pages with two of the stencils and elements from the die cut blocks. So this is the Art by Marlene accordion journal that's available as part of the 5.0 collection, and you can see that I've got quite a bit done on mine. So it measures about 4 inches by 6 inches, and inside, already pre-assembled for you, is a piece of 220 GSM paper that measures about 39 inches. It's a meter. So with all of the work actually done, all you have to do is get started on the background and then going ahead and putting what you want on the pages. So I've used distress oxide sprays on mine, on my original, and that's what I'm going to use again now. With that said, I have a work area that's wider than what you can see, so I'm going to work across the entire width. You'll see what's going on here, and I'm just going to be doing things on both ends so that ultimately the background ends up completely done. I have 5 colors of distress oxide sprays. So I have cracked pistachio, dusty concord, peacock feathers, seedless preserves, twisted citron, and worn lipstick. Now they need to be shaken. I've given them a preliminary shake off camera, so I'm just going to go ahead and do a little bit here. There are complementary colors in here. I have purple and green, and I have green and, excuse me, and I have kind of red and green, which is this here. So with that said, oxide sprays are not going to make a real muddy mess because they're going to overlap. They're opaque. As long as you don't mix them deliberately, you're not going to end up with anything that's really unattractive. So when I do this, I think I started with either twisted citron or cracked pistachio, so that's kind of what I'm going to do here. And I'm just moving this and spreading this out. And I didn't spray one color across the entire width of this. I just kind of picked my areas and went with that. Whatever you want to do obviously will work. And again, I apologize that you cannot see everything outside of here. Let's come in with the worn lipstick now that I've done those two. See how I'm getting coverage? It's kind of opaque, and so I'm not getting a mix of green and pink, which would usually make kind of a brownish color. All right. So that looks good. Now let's bring in, this is peacock feathers. So let's bring some of that in. Now what I'm going to do when I get through spraying is take what's left, what you see, the overspray here that's left, and I'm going to wet that and go back and dip things. But let's kind of get this done first. All right, so the last one is going to be Dusty Concord. All right, so let's slide all this out of the way. Now we'll edit this out. There's going to be some drying that has to happen before I can come back and dip things in. So I'm going to take my heat tool and dry what's here, and then I'll come back and I'll show you how I'm going to use what's left with some water to pick it up and get some interesting other patterns that kind of happen on here. With the paper dry, I'm going to take what's left here and spritz it with some water and kind of do my version of Tim Holtz's Distress Wrinkle Free technique, which is just to place this face down. And again, it's a little awkward because I'm working with this long length. But I'm going to place it face down and just touch it in various spots. And you can see that I get, whoops, sorry, I get that secondary pattern forming. So again, this is just the process. I do this over the entire length of the piece, usually with a little bit more care than what I'm doing now, but it is pretty difficult to work with this giant piece and keep it in the frame so that you can see it. But you get, as I said, those kind of interesting secondary patterns that form so that your background doesn't all look the same, and you can layer these colors in a way that, you know, you ordinarily couldn't, but because they're opaque, they're really not going to make a mess of one another. Let's just come and touch this in up here, and this is what we have. So once again, I'm going to shut the camera off for a second. We'll splice this together. I need to dry this and then clean this up, and then I'll show you what I did with the mask O1 and O2 to do a little bit of ghosting and lifting of colors and then adding some on top of that. All of this is dry, and the only other thing that I did that I forgot to mention is I take one of the colors, and typically one of the darker colors, and I'm going to take the the top out like this and just go ahead and drop some on there. That just adds some kind of big blotches of color. Now I'm actually just going to wipe this up because it's going to get in the way of what we're doing right now, and I've already got enough on there, but I did want you to see that that's the process for getting all of these big dots. So I have two of the new masks. This is, I believe this is mask 01 and this is mask 02. Now I think of this as more a stencil, but nevertheless it's mask 01 and 02. So one of the fun things that you can do to add pattern without adding any color is to just spritz through a stencil or a mask with water, because the oxide sprays are water reactive. So if I do that and I lift this up, you can see already the lifting that's happening as the water reactivates the oxide spray. I'm going to just give that a second and then come in and pat it. And I would do this across the entire width of the accordion journal, and you can see that you get this kind of secondary patterning that forms quite effortlessly. And then the other thing that I did was I took one distress spray stain. This happens to be Dusty Concord. And then I used, let's come up here, I used a little bit of this in various places just to add some patterning, and really it's that simple. You can do as much or as little of this as you like, and if you want to come along a little further and then go ahead and print what's left on the stencil or the mask, you can do that. And I could have done that with the plain water too, to get kind of the negative of whatever I had put through the stencil. So this is the process. Once you're done with this, then it's time to start thinking about grabbing elements from the die cut blocks and from that marvelous sticker book. And you can think about how you're going to arrange elements on the pages. Now, thematically, I decided to go ahead and use all of the female figures, whether it was a head or a full person standing. So next, I'm going to show you how I do that, kind of my thought process. And yeah, I'm going to bring in a little bit of galaxy glitter because it was sitting here on my table and I thought, well, why not? What you see here are the other bits and pieces that have gone into creating my accordion journal. So this is die cut block 5 and 6, or blocks 5 and 6. This is the brand new sticker book. This is galaxy glitter, which I did a video on about a week and a half ago. It happened to be sitting on my workbench and I thought, well, why not? And then these are the Dylusions Dyary glue sticks that work really, really well. And I'm using them to adhere everything to the accordion book page. So as I make my way through this journal, you can see that most of the pages at this point are done. In some cases, I've used just some of the text from the sticker book, but in all cases, the elements are basically the figures. I decided, well, except for this, which is kind of a head, but it's close, but I decided that that was thematically where I was going to go with this. So what I have left is this space here that I want to put one of the sticker quotes in, and then I have these two little sections here. And what I've done, and honestly, I have used elements, let's just slide this over here like this. I have used elements from both of the die cut blocks. I couldn't tell you which ones came from where, but this one, let's see what we got. So if you look at the back, you can see there's a picture of all of the pages in here, and I can see that this head is from, this is block 5. So this is from block 5. There's the head right there. The butterfly is also from this block. And what I'm going to do, because she doesn't have a body, I'm going to kind of give her this butterfly as a body instead, or at least as a resting place, so her head is not just kind of floating in air. Now the question becomes, do I want to center this? Do I want to move this off one side to the other? And I think what I'm going to do is slide this over a little bit so that it's skewed toward the outer edge of this page. I'm going to align this kind of like this, and then this element is also from that same block, and I'm going to put this here like this because they kind of work together. I'm probably going to put a little bit of text in here. So obviously the first thing I need to do is glue these down. Now when I do this, the way that I like to do it is to take a clean piece of paper, if I could actually get my hands on one, and I use this as my base. I can never promise myself that my workbench is clean, but if I start on a fresh piece of paper with clean hands, I know that I'm less likely to make a mess of whatever it is that I'm working on. So what I want to do is remember that I need to leave this head about this far up from the bottom, and then I'll have room to get the butterfly placed over the top of it. So all I'm going to do is just grab the glue stick. Now, the one thing that Di always says, and every class I take with her, she says it, and I smile and inwardly think, yep, you're right, every time she says it, is that the difference between her glue sticks and everybody else's is that these work. And honestly, that's the truth. I have never been as successful with a glue stick as I am with these. I forget what the normal price is, but right now we have the entire Dyary collection on sale at 25% off. And these come in a 3-pack. Your cost for 3 of these glue sticks is $1.87, which is a really extraordinary price to begin with. But when you couple that with the fact that the bloody things actually do what they're supposed to do, which is to adhere one thing to another, they are a bargain that can't be beat. So I want to run the glue all the way off like that, and then I'm going to remember about where I was here, and then go ahead and place this. And if I just kind of come in and do that, yep, that looks about right. So I'm just going to put this in place. Do the same thing with the, whoops, with the butterfly. Now when you do this, or when I do this, I always try to make certain that when I put this next piece face down, it's not in the leftover glue from the last one. I mean, it's going to dry pretty much matte anyway, but why make things harder than they have to be? So I'm just going to align this so that I've got the antenna covering the bottom of her neck in the way that I envisioned. Go ahead and put that in place. And I'm going to just grab a paper towel. I'm getting glue on my fingers, so it's kind of time to clean them off. And then picking again another clean spot here, I'll just go ahead and use the glue stick to get this piece, this piece ready. And then go ahead and put it in here like this. Now, the one thing that I didn't mention that I had already done to all of these pieces, when you slide this out, when you take one of these shapes out of a book, you can see that there are little tiny tabs that are what are holding it in place in the die cut block. So what I like to do once I get this out, if you look, for example, right there, I like to take a small pair of scissors. I just think it makes for a little bit cleaner, neater look. I'll just go around and trim off the tabs. And a lot of times if I can't see them, I can feel them. But I'll just trim off those tabs all the way around. I think it just makes for a neater presentation when it comes time to glue these in place. All right, now the thing with these glue sticks, that noise means that the cap is on tightly and it's not going to dry out. So you really want to make certain that you click that closed when you work with it. So let's bring in the Galaxy Glitter for just one second. This color is ultraviolet. It's got turquoise and purpley pink in here. It works beautifully with this particular colorway, so it's what I went, and honestly, what was up on my table, so that was another reason that I went with it. There's a lot of different ways that you can put this on. I'm a big finger painter, and so it's as simple, honestly, as this. Now, you can put this on before you put your figures on, or you can do what I'm doing, which is to just kind of scooch some around afterward. You can use a little, you can use a lot. As always, it's a matter of personal preference. I love glitter, so I find this very enjoyable to work with, and I like the look that I get from it. So coming back to the sticker book, I will say that these are really well done. One of the things that I was impressed with is the fact that the adhesive works really well. So I know that there is a particular sentiment that I want to put in this spot, and it is, let's see, where is it? It is this one right here. It says, "Let people see the real, raw, imperfect, flawed, quirky, crazy, funny, scared, serious, beautiful, magical human being that you are." Couldn't have said it better myself. Honestly, I think we are all who we are, and I found that I need to accept myself for who I am and go with it, and I find that these words are really a good way to encourage myself to remember and believe those things. Now, you can put these in full length the way that I have right here, or you can choose a spot and you can trim them. In some cases, if I come back to this section right here, oops, sorry, this is all over the place. Some of these were actually a little bit too long to fit the 4-inch width of the panel, so I had to cut them. You can cut them as a design choice if you want. So I could trim this right here. You can space them really close together, or you can separate them out. Again, it's always what works for you on any given day. If I want to overlap, I can. Now, when I do this, one of the things that I try to do is fold the page, whether it's a mountain or a valley fold, and then go ahead and press this on the other side, and then just press it again, and then I'll just grab the last section of this, and I think again that I'm going to cut it, but this time I'm going to cut it so that the left side is shorter than the right. Put that right there, and again I'm eyeballing, trying to make certain that I keep these kind of straight. Oops, this one is upside down. And honestly, it's that simple. Now I will find something else to go here on this last panel. I might bring in some more of the galaxy glitter. I haven't really decided yet, but for all intents and purposes, bar a couple of more embellishments and maybe a touch more galaxy glitter, this is actually ready to go. It's done, and I'm really, really pleased with it. I have the other one. I haven't done anything with the back cover. Haven't decided about that yet. I have the other one that I added the background to a few minutes ago that is now ready to go too, so I could come in and start grabbing other elements from the die cut block. Since I've used a lot of the figures, now I can start incorporating some of the other elements. But honestly, this is it. I mean, these accordion journals really are marvelous to work with. I like the quality, I like the paper, I just in general like working with them, and I think you're going to have fun with them too.